My dear player, I knew you'd come here. I need your help now more than anyone. Help me restore my good name. I was building a very special new machine. It was to be my greatest work, but it was destroyed. The key pieces, the living elements, were lost. You must find those pieces and complete my greatest work. I'll be hoping to meet you soon, dear friend. In the flesh, yours, Henry Stout.
We'll be right back. Are you coming home tonight? The time is passing by. When life is nearby, will I?
Far away from civilization, to be the man who will turn the tide of war when everything else fails. Millions of lives are at stake, and I have to save them, finish my work, break the code before it breaks me. Time is not on my side. Determination means everything now. For too long I've been misled, but the answer was there. Right in front of me.
...1980 started like the decades before it. On a slow Tuesday afternoon where the Atlantic and Indian Oceans met, the Penrose appeared. An object of untold technological abundance that would advance civilization on all frontiers. Hunger and disease eradicated. Energy mastered and mortality conquered. For a fleeting moment, mankind forgot about its differences and progressed as one. But peace would be short-lived. Humanity would war, and desolation would ensue.
Thank you. boxing, baseball, football. Today, people can watch sports on television. They can admire their heroes closer than ever. But me, all I can see is corruption, money, and even sometimes, murder.
You destroyed my life, but I'm gonna pay you back.
Thank you. Shall we play storytelling?
So, once upon a time, a little fox was traveling through the world.
And the maze appeared from under the ground.
Wait, stop! Maze again?
Mazes are cool.
Finally, the fox went out of the labyrinth and found himself near the woods.
But the forest was suspiciously deserted.
We headed where man had never set foot before. To the most astounding archaeological find of our time. A civilization. A civilization hidden in the ice. It was then that it happened. I thought I wanted to be dead. But my ordeal was just beginning.
I have kept this diary hidden away from you, locked inside the Cinema Rosa. I knew you'd come looking for me. You always do. You were convinced that somewhere in the library lay a book with the answers to everything. When you couldn't find it, you started ripping out pages. Months passed and two things got worse. I was away on business, and when I came back, you were not even looking at me. I saw the fire in your eyes. Smoke filling the projection. Everything we had worked towards collapsing in a single afternoon. I slept with my door locked that night, afraid that whatever had possessed you would soon possess me. And together, we would slip into the same darkness.
This is lead researcher Archer calling any survivors on this frequency. Is anyone out there? I repeat, this is lead researcher Archer calling for any survivors on this frequency. Is anyone... Rose?
This is Nikola Tesla speaking, and unless it wasn't already obvious, this ship is under strict quarantine. There is to be no movement on or off the Helios.
Ada, what the hell is going on?
There's been an accident. Or sabotage. It doesn't matter. We need to get off this ship.
Stop!
You can't run from my throne.
When I was a little girl, I used to look up at the sky and wonder. Now I can't see the sky anymore. I drive between the skyscrapers, curious neon giants that stretch out to infinity. My shift has just begun, and this will be a long night. My car hums between the never-ending billboards. cast a spell. Guide me through the night. What makes this city isn't in the streets. It isn't on the news. It's the people that live here. And the niggling fear that at the core of this place is a pulsing heart fueled by consumption. This is where I live. In the rain. Among the clouds.
They promised us Deus, but they never let us in. So we live in Columni, hoping one day to go up. Some dream of it. Some fight for it. But most simply don't care. To go up, you must journey down. To reach the inside, you must go outside. Forward, you must go back. To touch Deus, you must pass through Machina.
私はこの子の夢の中にしか存在しない影のようなもの。はあ、変な夢。
journey. A dangerous journey. Get ready for a thrilling interactive adventure.
Please don't interact with me.
With intense action.
God damn it!
In the first ever Cyanide and Happiness video game.
Now, the secret to surviving out in the radioactive wild is to cover your own face in toxic sludge so you can fit in and not draw attention to yourself.
I wouldn't do that if I were...
I've never been down there before.
Down?
Diving.
This is Alex.
What's up, man? Conrad.
Good to finally meet you, Conrad. This is Brad, by the way, my little bro.
So is everybody on board and ready to go?
Who wants to find some sunken treasure?
You good?
More or less.
What do you know about this wreck?
Just rumors.
It was insane. It was like traveling through time.
Should have never gone down to that plane in the first place.
Oh, damn.
Every single thing you bring back has an essence. I told you to leave everything down there alone. We have unexpected guests.
Julia! Guys!
Yeah. Times are hard.
Dean, you're my best friend. I've known him for years. I'd do anything for him and those kids.
I've known Dean for a while now. He loves his kids. His wife. Well, she's no longer with us.
But looking after two kids on your own? It's not easy. Love them. Love them to bits. In fact, to go to the end of the universe for them. Would you?
Thank you.
Your easel. Don't forget to take it when you leave. It must mean a great deal to you.
I see you're a painter. I'm quite partial to sandy beaches. This is splendid. It will be the prized piece of my sitting room.
If you haven't got lodging for the night, feel free to stay at the inn. I'll leave the upstairs room unlocked for you.
Chicken, the elders once said. Grace, tenacity, determination, but above all, pure cleverness. A being so splendid that it had to come with an equally brave partner. This mighty being here is Edgar. It's magnificent. Friend and protector, working days and nights to keep their haven unharmed. But what would happen if chaos came to strike? if their lives were threatened. Or worse, if squashes ran out. Only when a man is backed against a wall will his true self be revealed. A man or a chicken?
Thank you.